what's done well and not so well in the following interviews. Be sure to write down your observations in the following scenes.
Hi, my name is Jamie and I'm calling from the Oregon Public Health Division. Recently, several people in Reedsport and the surrounding area got sick with an intestinal infection called salmonellosis. We're interviewing people in the community to gather some information and figure out what's causing people to get sick, and that can help protect others from becoming ill. I'm hoping to talk with a male between the ages of 20 and 49. Is there someone in the household who fits that description?
Yeah, I'm 33.
We've been interviewing the people who've been sick to find out what sorts of food they ate and other activities they did that might put them at risk for infection. We're also asking the same questions of people who didn't get sick. That way we can compare foods that sick people and well people ate, and that helps us figure out what might have caused the illness.
That sounds good.
Great. First, I'd like to ask about the kinds of places where you might have eaten in the 7 days before August 20th. This may help jog your memory about specific foods you might have eaten, which I'll ask about in a few minutes. So I'm asking about places at which you had something to eat between Monday, August 13th and Sunday, August 19th.
All right.
Did you eat anything at any fast food restaurants?
No, I don't eat fast food.
Sit-down restaurants?
Yeah, I ate breakfast that weekend at Cup and Saucer, and then we also ate at a Japanese restaurant called Matsuya.
Okay. Any other meals at sit-down restaurants that week?
No, I don't believe so.
Any meals at a bakery, dessert, or pastry shop?
No, I don't believe so.
Hey, Carrie, are there more cookies left?
Yeah, there's lots of cookies left.
Can you get me one?
Sure. Okay. Just one?
Yeah, just one. And coffee, too.
Cream and sugar. Cream and sugar, got it.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Sorry about that.
Any meals at a grocery store deli or other kind of deli?
No, on both counts.
Now I'm going to ask a few questions about foods typically prepared outside the home, like the foods you got from a restaurant or takeout place. So between Monday, August 13th and Sunday, August 19th, did you have any hamburger at a fast food place? That is, at a place where you would pay before you eat.
No, I don't believe so.
Hamburgers at any other restaurant that wasn't a fast food place?
No, I don't think so.
Any sandwich that might have had sprouts in it?
No, I hate sprouts.
Any sushi or sashimi or ceviche?
I've only heard of sushi of those three, so no, I don't think so.
Any kind of burrito or wrap?
No.
Smoothies?
No, definitely not.
Finally, I have a few questions about pets and animal contact. Again, between Monday, August 13th and Sunday, August 19th, did you have any contact with dogs or puppies?
No, besides walking through parks, no.
Cats or kittens?
Yeah, I actually visited my sister that week and she has cats that I play with.
Any contact with chickens, turkeys, or poultry?
No, definitely not.
Other pet birds of any kind?
No.
Reptiles, including lizards, snakes, turtles, and tortoises?
Yeah, I actually have a pet boa.
Any contact with amphibians, like frogs, toads, or salamanders?
No, to all three.
Goldfish or aquarium fish?
No, also not.
Contact with rats, mice, or gerbils?
Yeah, I actually buy mice for my pet
boa down the street at a pet food store.
Are those frozen or live mice?
They're alive. I actually like to dangle the little guys into my boa's cage, until she locks in on them. And then I slowly lower them in and she comes in and wraps around them. It's really quite something to watch.
Ooh, that sounds so gross. I hate snakes and mice. Any contact with exotic pets or pocket pets like ferrets, pygmy hedgehogs, or giant Gambian pouched rats?
Gambian pouch rats? No.
And any visits to pet stores, swap meets, or other places where animals or birds were sold or shown?
No.
Okay. That's all the questions that I have. Thanks so much for doing this interview. By comparing your responses with other people who got sick, we can often get important clues as to what caused their illness, and that can help keep other people from getting sick. Sometimes after we review the results and compare them, other important questions might come up. If we need to talk with you again, could we get a hold of you at this same number?
Yeah, this number's fine.
Perfect. Thank you again for your time. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Please refer to the Good, the Bad, and the Ugly answer key to see how you did for scene one.
Hi, this is Alyssa Boston with the Oregon Public Health Division. Are the parents of Ryan Robinson available?
Yes, this is Julie, Ryan's mother.
I'm with the Oregon Public Health Division, and I'm calling today to gather some information about your son Ryan's recent illness. Ryan and several other people in your area have been sick from the same type of infection, and it's caused by an organism called Salmonella.
Yes, Ryan's pediatrician told us about it.
Well, we at the Public Health Division are working with folks at Clackamas County Health Department to find out what may have made Ryan and others sick in order to help prevent others from becoming sick.
Oh, thank you for doing that. He was really sick.
Well, to begin with, I'd like to ask some questions about places you may shop and restaurants where Ryan may have eaten, and then I'll also ask about specific foods that Ryan may have eaten at home, school, or other places during the week before he became ill.
All of the information will be kept confidential. Is this a good time for you?
Sure.
Great. So when exactly did Ryan first get sick?
Well, he had a bit of a runny nose and a cough about a month ago, but that may have not been the same thing.
Thinking specifically of his recent illness, when did those symptoms start?
It was on Thursday.
And which Thursday?
Let me get to a calendar. The 16th.
Okay, that's consistent with information my colleagues at the county collected. Do you remember what time Thursday morning?
It had to have been, we'd already fixed breakfast, and the kids had eaten, so it had to have been between 7:30 and 10:30.
And what's your best guess of the exact time?
Well, my husband had taken the kids to school.
So it had to have been 10:30.
Okay, and what time were his first symptoms with vomiting or diarrhea?
It was 10:30, and the first symptoms were diarrhea.
And was anyone else in the household sick with diarrhea and vomiting in the week before Ryan got sick?
No one else was sick in the house.
Okay. Did Ryan go to the emergency room because of this illness?
Yes, he did twice.
Don't you have a regular health care provider you could have used?
Yes, she's great. Ryan just became sick after hours, so we had to go to the emergency room.
And did Ryan have to stay in the hospital overnight?
No, he did not.
All right. Next, I'm going to ask about where the food that Ryan ate during the 7 days before he got sick came from. So this isn't necessarily where you shopped on those days, but where the food he ate during that time came from.
Okay.
Did any of the food come from grocery stores or supermarkets?
Yes, it did. It came from Winco, Grocery Outlet, and Safeway.
Anything from large warehouse stores?
Well, yes, I do have items from Costco around the house.
And he wouldn't have had any homegrown produce, would he?
Well, he possibly could have had collard greens and kale. But I'm not sure.
Well, if you're not sure.
No. Yeah, he didn't have any of that.
Okay. I also want to ask about specific restaurants and fast food places that Ryan ate during the week before he got sick. Again, that's between February 9th and 15th. I'll give you the name of restaurants and you let me know, yes or no, if Ryan ate there during that time. Sound okay?
Yes, it does.
Great. Did he eat at A&W?
No.
Baskin-Robbins?
No.
Dairy Queen?
You know, I think he did get a dip cone there at one time.
Okay. KFC?
No.
Famous Julie's?
Oh, wow. We did go there a few months back. Man, that place was filthy.
Mm-hmm.
Talk about grungy.
That place was gross. I'm surprised we all didn't get sick.
Oh.
I mean, this place was unbelievable. It's amazing how a place like that can stay open.
Oh, wow.
And man, those fries? Ugh. So greasy.
Mm-hmm.
And that calamari. Mmm, gag me with a spoon.
So definitely not one of your better dining out experiences?
You can say that again.
Okay, well, thinking of other places Ryan ate, again, during the 7 days before he got sick, did he eat at Panda Express?
No.
Taco Bell?
No.
Burgerville?
No.
Okay, great. Well, that's all the questions I have for now, and can you give me a second more of your time to review all of the information I've collected? I want to make sure I'm not missing anything.
Yes.
Okay, well, it looks like we've covered everything for now. If there's additional information we need, we may have to contact you again. Is this the best number and time to reach you?
Yes, this is the best number. During weekdays, please.
Thanks so much for your time and taking part in this interview. This information is extremely valuable in helping us track down the source of these infections and in preventing additional illness within the community.
You are very welcome. If you find out what caused Ryan to become sick, will you call me?
I'm not quite sure if we're able to do that. I'll have to run that by the lead investigator and get back to you.
Thank you very much for doing this work.
We hope nobody becomes sick like Ryan was. He was really sick.
Great, well, I'm glad he's doing better. Thanks again very much for your time. I'll make sure and talk to the lead investigator and get back to you.
Okay, bye now.
Okay, bye.
Please refer to the Good, the Bad, and the Ugly answer key to see how you did for scene 2.